In less than 3 minutes, let's talk about the 5 common budget strategies. The 50-50 pay yourself first strategy is my budget strategy to achieve financial independence. The pay yourself first strategy is for people who prioritize savings over expenses. Now, it doesn't mean that you should save money and not pay your bills. This strategy will require you to have high enough income to achieve the 50% savings rate or live in an area with a low cost of living. For example, if you make $80,000 a year, your goal is to save at least $40,000 a year. And as your income goes up, your savings rate should be going up at the same time. However, it'll be hard for you to use this budget strategy if you're in a toxic debt like credit cards, personal loans, or student loans. You can check out my other video about how I save over 60% of my income to achieve financial independence. The zero-based budget strategy is what I used back in 2014 and 2015 to tackle my debt. This budget strategy is very common for people who are prioritizing expenses and paying off their debt. So for example, if you make $3,000 a month and your essential expenses are $2,000, you're gonna put the $1,000 towards your debt, and then at the end of each month, whatever you have left, you're gonna put every penny towards the debt that you have, so you're gonna zero out your budget. So you're gonna put whatever you have left towards your debt, and if you're not in debt, you're gonna put that towards your savings. The 50-30-20 budget strategy is where you divide your income into 3 categories: 50% needs, 30% wants, and 20% towards your savings or debt repayment. So what that means is that 50% of your income will go to your essential expenses, 30% will go to whatever you want to spend on, like your dining out, restaurants, or entertainment, and 20% will go to your savings or paying off your debt. The envelope budgeting strategy is a very old school way where you put cash in each envelope and you're gonna categorize them or label them as bills, groceries, gas, or utilities. You don't have to use cash like the old school way, but you can use a spreadsheet where you just kind of label what your spending categories are and you set a limit to each of the category. The value-based budget strategy will require you to take some time to figure out what really matters to you, and then you're gonna adjust your spending accordingly to whatever plan that you come up with. So every month after you pay off all of your essential expenses and you put some money away into your savings or investment, you're gonna look at all of your spending categories and figure out what really matters to you. If you believe spending $100 every month towards a new restaurant because that brings you value, then you're gonna put that into your value-based strategy. Another example is that some people believe getting a physical therapy or body massage or mental health therapy session brings them value. If you believe they can bring value to you, you're gonna add them to your value-based budget strategy. Thanks for watching. Check out these 2 3-minute videos as well as the new fire video coming out tomorrow, Sunday at 9 a.m. Have a good one.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more fire videos.